Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
And that's the 24th, right? 24th?
Our next meeting is the 24th.
Okay.
Item number five on the new agenda, 33311 and 33631, Aurora Road, Solon Square LLC, for permit of parcels 95403040, 016, and 017. This is a resubmittal of a previously approved lot consolidation, which now includes some corrected items. I will make a motion to schedule a public hearing.
Second that.
Seconded by Tony. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Item number six, 5163 Barrington Court, Danilo and Winthrop Homes Incorporated, not parallel to the street variance.
Would you like me to pass this to the table?
I think the overhead's working now.
I'm Rick Danilo from Danilo and Winthrop Homes. I'm here tonight to request a not parallel to the front building line for the home that we plan on building. The home has the minimal footprint of pretty much any other home in the neighborhood. There is a topographical challenge to building the home parallel to the line with a steep grade going down to a low area on the lot. We've designed the home to be pretty much as compact width-wise as possible.
Move that to the center of the yellow square.
We're here.
There you go. Thank you.
So the light line is what we are proposing, and the dark line is what code will allow. This area is the lowest point of the lot, which obviously we want to stay clear of. We're trying to get the home to be on the highest part of the lot as possible. So this is about a 30, this would, being parallel to the front line, would move the back corner of the building 30 feet to the right, which would place it on the downward slope, almost to the bottom of the downward slope.
I guess this is exactly what a practical difficulty is.
And it's also, this is not a precedent in this this subdivision. The lot right next door was also approved for a not parallel variance for a similar reason.
I'll make a motion for a not parallel with street variance for 5163 Barrington Court.
Second.
Seconded by the mayor. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Rick, this will be before city council next meeting, September 16th.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank
Have
you,
a good
sir.
Night.
You too. Item number seven, 31250 Cannon Road, for accessory structure location variance. Is the applicant present? Since we do not have the applicant present, that's been our process, our procedure in the past, is I think we have some questions.
Motion
for this.
To table.
Very good, thank you. Seconded.
I'll second.
Seconded by Tony. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Item number eight, 6653 Dunedin Avenue, Fred Vanderpeet, for a 9-foot minimum cumulative side yard setback variance. Good evening.
Evening. Good evening. Well, Fred Vanderpeet, 6653 Dunedin Avenue.
I don't have it. I did this quick sketch.
Looks very good.
As much as I can improvise.
We don't permit improvisation.
So you were hoping the video didn't work.
I think you all did that. No, I'm just saying.
So as you can see, the patio, I'm looking to for a patio variance to expand and broaden. So currently the patio is 16 foot by 12. That's pre-existing. I'm looking to bump it out a little bit to make it flush with the house edge, as well as run it all the way across 23 and a half feet to expand for more just entertaining and more accommodations associated with furniture associated with the patio to enjoy the summer, and then bump it out just a little bit more from the 12 foot to the 15 and a half. and that's the variance I'm looking for, and just to upgrade the patio.
Commission members?
It sounds like you're going to be able to entertain a lot of people out there, and we all expect invitations from you.
There we go.
Make the motion for the 9-foot minimum cumulative side yard setback variance for 6653 Dundeen Avenue.
I'll second.
Seconded by Roger. Discussion?
The only thing is that I know you're aware you still, even with this approval, you'd have to apply for a permit for the...
Yes, I would have to get the permit after your approval.
Just want to make sure you knew this didn't cover that for you.
Yeah, I got it. I have to get that in the letter here.
Okay.
Thank you.
Move a second.
They did already.
Seconded by Roger.
Amended.
Okay. Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Fred, this will be before City Council on September 16th.
September 16th. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Item number 9, 33321 Aurora Road, Earth Fair for Mid-America Management for site plan modification for shopping carts. Is the applicant present? Seeing none, keeping with our past practices, I'll make a motion to table. Seconded by...
Everybody.
Tony.
Everybody.
Discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Item number 10, 30285 Solon Industrial Parkway, ROM Properties, 2,000 square foot minimum business area variance. Good evening.
Good evening. Tim Stacy, 31951 Sedfield Oval.
Okay. Do you have any drawings, Tim?
I do have them.
Throwing you a curve.
It's a change up.
You're looking with Roger.
I know, I'm hanging out with Roger Newberry too much.
There's the building. And here's the actual space.
Okay, for the record, the code requires 8,000 square feet, and you're requesting 6,000. Would you like to tell us what you're going to be doing in there?
It's a private baseball academy. Okay. And the reason I chose this space is because I have the opportunity to expand at this location.
And when do you plan to start this? I'm trying to give you a...
Hopefully by October.
Okay.
I have a window of 5 months.
Okay.
When the weather's bad, the kids are in. When the weather's good, the kids are out.
Okay. Seems like a good solution to a vacant building.
I did get a phone call from Councilman Bill Russo, and he's is supportive of this project, and I don't see any reason not to support it, so.
Bill also contacted me and voiced his support for this project. So I'll make a motion for a discussion.
I'm curious. You're going to run pitching batting cages in here? Is that the idea?
I will have cages, tunnels, whatever you might call them.
Mm-hmm.
They're nets that are, the netting will be 14 foot wide, 12 foot high, up to 70 foot long, where we can give pitching instruction, hitting instruction.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It'll be
okay.
Turfed.
And the way they're going, the tunnels are going to be arranged is essentially across the building, from front to back, from the loading doors to the front.
No. It'll go. This area will be taken out.
Okay.
So it'll leave an open area. The one cage will go this way.
Perfect.
There'll be a division, you know, a gap, and then another cage will go this way, and then a third cage will go this way.
And you got room left over for infield practice?
Well, the cages will be like curtains,
mm-hmm.
so that you can open them up, and this whole area here can be used as infield. And there will be AstroTurf, even though it's turf. turf in there from wall to wall.
Okay. And my last question is, when you expand, the idea is to expand into the area opposite the offices, right?
This way.
Yeah. Oh, in that direction?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Just trying to support you here.
Oh, I appreciate it.
Little free advertising. It's going to be the greatest facility in Solon.
It's the only facility in Solon.
Well, for the moment. it's great. I look forward to having you be a great success in the city.
Thank you.
I really do.
I appreciate that.
Rob, the only question I would have of you, any concerns about parking here with this? Is this all?
There's no parking variance involved with this.
Good.
Well, let me explain this, Bill. When my hours of operation come into play, the offices leave. The kids are in school. So when the offices are clearing out is when my traffic comes in. At the very earliest, 3:30, 3:45 in the afternoon. And then, of course, on weekends.
Now, if someone wanted to sign up with your, what age group are you?
From 10U through 18U.
And if you wanted to sign your son or daughter up, who would you call?
We're private.
Oh, you're private?
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, we're not open to the public. I don't have the coin-operated machines, where you can come in off the street and put the tokens in. We're private. I currently have 10 teams, under my umbrella, so to speak, that we train. I do team training.
Okay.
And I teach teams.
Okay. Very good. Any further questions?
I'd be pleased to make the motion for a 2,000 square foot minimum business area variance.
Second.
Second by Mackey. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Okay, Timmy will be before City Council at the next meeting Monday, September 16th.
Thank you.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Okay. Minor alterations?
Thank you.
We have two minors. The first is the annex project, which you recall part of the issue there was landscaping for the project. At the rear, Pettibone Road is here. At the rear of the project, you had approved landscaping here, which was giant arborvitae. The retention pond location and the way that there's not much land between the retention pond and the parking lot created a problem. So they want to instead submit a new landscape plan, which would include Norway spruce. And that has been approved by the affected property owner back here and in writing, and it's been approved by our landscape architect.
Okay. I think we're happy with that.
Great. And the other item is the Nestle facility main plant. And just making some alterations to the rear of the building. What I'm going to show you is consistent with this area of the building facing the 422. And so that this is oriented the same way for that area I just showed you. And there are two man doors proposed here in a new landing. There is a glass entry door that would actually be just replaced with an opaque type door. There is a temporary roll-up garage door that will be located here. What they're doing is they're making some changes to the assembly line area, from what I understand, inside. And this door will be temporary. It will be bricked over once they're done with those changes. Then there is an existing 3-foot wide man door with a 4-foot wide landing here. They're altering that to a 4-foot wide man door and a 7-foot wide landing, so an alteration there. And then finally, an existing man door in this location will be filled in. So a bunch of stuff, but all of them minor.
Okay. I think we're satisfied with that also.
Okay, that's all I got.
Okay. I neglected at the beginning of the meeting to welcome Lieutenant Joe Eisenruth to our meeting.
And so, my comments.
Oh, I just retract that. But I did want to charge him with some homework. As we discussed briefly in caucus, some concern has been raised about the Menchie's sidewalk park patio area, was whether there should be some bollards or fencing to protect the client sitting there. So, Joe, you have homework. I want to make a motion to have Joe report back to us our next meeting with an extensive report on whether it needs some enhancements there, so.
Term paper?
Term paper.
Thousand words.
So we have a second?
I'll second.
Second, right, Roger, discussion, roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
Mayor, now comments from the commission, beginning with the mayor.
I too would like to just say welcome to Joe, although he has been at some of our planning meetings before. He will now be the permanent fixture for the Fire Prevention Bureau. So Joe, anything that we can do to help you, and we welcome you to our planning commission. So, and then secondly, I'd just like to say congratulations to the Solon High School Marching Band. This past weekend, they hosted the 7th annual Band Bash. Where over 1,000 musicians from 10 different schools got to showcase their talents. And although all the bands are very impressive, the Solon High School Marching Band just does so much for our community, for the school. They're really a spectacular group, but through all their concerts, the parades, and just all the sporting events, they always just seem to make things just so much more entertaining. So congratulations to them, and I wish them a good year. And that's it for tonight.
Thank you. Tony?
Welcome, Joe. We have a great time here. We hope you will, too.
Roger?
Yeah, tagging along with what the mayor said, I had the opportunity last Friday night to attend the Solon High School football game. First time I've done that in about 10 years. It was great to be back. It's fun to go to the Stewart Field and watch the teams compete. Unfortunately, the results weren't quite what we hoped they would be, but the football players did very well, and the band was, of course, spectacular. And Joe, welcome aboard. You know, we do expect a vocal presence here, as well as just a smiling face and a grin. Although I think that's what Al Benedict did for about 15 in those years. Thank you.
Mackie?
Welcome. Good to see you, Joe. And we also have some high school students that came in. I think they were, is this punishment for you guys, or is this part of a class?
We're from Kent State University.
Okay.
Well, why don't you come on up and introduce yourselves?
Yeah, we'd love to hear from you guys.
Oh, you're stuck now, buddy.
It's not even 8 o'clock yet.
I want to hear more about this architecture thing, too. A little knowledge of that.
You might study that.
I'm on TV. Yeah, so me and my friends, we are from Kent State University. We do architecture. And for Methods and Materials 1, we are supposed to observe architectural planning meeting, mm-hmm. So and write a report about it. So we chose this one.
Well, excellent. Well, thank you.
See, another term paper. We'll expect it in 2 weeks.
1,000 words.
Yeah.
Now, what kind of grade did we get?
It was kind of boring today for you.
There wasn't much for you to do.
Yeah, it was kind of boring today.
We have a police officer outside.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome back anytime.
Yeah, thank you. And now we can vouch that you guys were all here. You vouch your friends that you guys were all here. You get credit for today.
You've been on TV. It's broadcast all over the cable networks.
Thanks for coming, guys. That's it for me.
Thank you. Rob?
I just welcomed Joe. And I think the chairman, I think you said he was going to sing the national anthem. But I guess that's the next meeting. So.
Lon?
I guess I should say something so anybody reading the minutes would know I was here.
Put you up in present.
Welcome, Joe.
Carol?
I'll welcome Joe, too.
Donna?
Welcome, Joe.
Gary? Welcome, Joe. Joe, welcome. Comments from the audience? Would anyone like to address the commission? Seeing none, we'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
By the mayor.
Second.
Seconded by Roger. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Ms. Richmond?
Yes.
This meeting is adjourned.